Amen, amen. So can you do me a favor and can you thank God for Mark Tatum and Anthony Mitchell and Matthew Mitchell? Amen. Yeah, that's good news right there, because this is our future. It's not only our future, but this is the present generation. So we need to thank God that these children are in the church, because we have to train up these children and keep them so they don't stray far from the church. Amen. Let us stand and let us be glad and rejoice with our praise and worship team.
Well, hallelujah. I was looking for my
Jesus.
It's all right. I was being cool. Boom. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, come on. You can do better than that. Those three babies got up and gave their whole soul. You can at least match it. Worship God together. Who has a mindset for worship this morning? Who's ready? I came in ready, and then they got me excited at 9 o'clock. Now I'm doubly ready. Hallelujah. So we're just gonna sing a little bit about the goodness of Jesus. You know, he has a great name. I know you think your name is cool, but Jesus is a great name. Hallelujah. So we love to call him the name of Jesus, right?
One,
so if you know it, sing it.
Two,
and if you don't, listen
one,
to the verse,
two.
You got it, right?
254.
Wait,
265.
Saying, you know, when you put together something that you spent all week on, you know, some Lego something, or if you go back a couple of decades, people used to IKEA furniture. Holla. I swear that it's more parts in the box than the paper says. And I put it together and it's almost together, but if I put a baby in that crib, something's gonna happen. So I have to go back to the directions. The problem is I can't just put new bolts in. I have to take it completely apart.
That's right.
To re-put it back together.
Yeah.
And God, sometimes after you have spent your whole lifetime putting yourself in place together, and God's like, that's not quite right. Take out this piece. No, we just got to start over. Break.
Yeah.
And it hurts sometimes. It feels like, but Lord, I invested all this time. But God says, I have to break you to rebuild you. But the great thing is he does it with grace. So it doesn't feel like it does when your friend breaks you. Hallelujah. So we're just going to sing a little bit about being gracefully broken. See, when you say, Lord, take all I have. This is my praise. And I want you to magnify it. This is my gift you gave me. And I want you to glorify it. I want you to increase it. When kids used to say, Mama, I got these money. What do you have? I have these money. And your mother will then put your money, your 20 cents, with her $40, and then you get the gain. That's what God does. He adds the increase. Hallelujah. So we're just going to go in for a minute, because some of the people up here have been broken. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Take all.
You've
been there before?
2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4.
This day, Lord, thank you for everything you've given us, Lord. Thank you for the impossible and unfathomable things, Lord. Thank you for the world that we live in, Lord. Thank you for oxygen to breathe, Lord. Thank you for everything, Lord. Thank you for the blood that flows inside us, Lord. Thank you for our heart continuing to beat, Lord. Thank you for all of our special gifts that you've given us, Lord, specifically, Lord. I ask that you continue to put a special blessing on us, Lord, as we go through this week, Lord. Thick and thin, Lord, can you just hold our hands as we go through this narrow path, Lord? Like they said in the song, demons tremble in your name, Lord. So I ask that you could just hold our hands, Lord, and that we'll be able to walk through, Lord, and that we'll be able to go.
Yeah.
but make sure it's the one with our blue and green logo. Yeah. You can also give by putting your tithes in a basket with cash or a check made out to New Bethel Baptist Church. You can also text to give to the number 202-759-6222. That's 202-759-6222. Now, all of you might not have money, because if you're a kid like me, you don't have a job. So you can also give by presenting your talents or taking time to give back. The Bible teaches us this in Mark chapter 12, verses 41 through 44. It says, Jesus sat down opposite the place where the offerings were being put and watched the crowd putting their money into the temple treasury. Many rich people threw in large amounts, but a poor widow came and put in 2 copper coins worth only a few cents. Calling his disciples to him, Jesus said, truly I tell you, this poor widow has put more into the treasury than all the others. They gave out of their wealth, but she, out of her poverty, put in everything, all she had to live on. Let us pray. Dear Lord, thank you for all the people who can give and bless those who are unable. Thank you for those who give what they do have, including their time and talent. I pray that everyone here today is able to feel your presence and will get closer to you. Continue to bless the youth and young adults so they can be the next generation of leaders to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. Bless all the leaders who were able to make this service happen. Lord, please keep all the children safe as we go to school and our extracurricular activities, and bless our families and parents and friends. In Jesus' name, amen.
Jesus will. I don't know why they stand up. Wow. Come on. Come on, y'all. Start. Here we go.
Play, you bastard. My
E-flat.
Good morning, New Bethel.
This is urban, man.
I can't hear y'all. Good morning, New Bethel. My name is Nathaniel Mitchell, and on behalf of all of the youth here, welcome to the experience. The Word of God says in Matthew 19, verses 13 through 15, one day the children were brought to Jesus in hope that he would heal them and lay his hands on them. The disciples shooed them off, but Jesus intervened. He says, let the children alone. Don't prevent them from coming to me, for God's kingdom is made up of people like these. And they were healed. Jesus is clear that the kingdom of God is for the children and the youth. But just like the disciples, many people dismiss us. They say, we're too young. You have not any experiences. You don't know anything. But today, the children and youth of New Bethel want you to hear and understand that we do experience the things y'all go through. We do have to go to God in times of need, just like all of you. In a few moments, you are going to hear the word delivered by Mark Anthony and my sister, Nina Mitchell. They don't preach like pastor, but they will show you what we go through in our lives. But before their powerful testimonies,